let's use a different method to test the transistor. We'll use it to switch a component on and off, in this case an LED. There are a few ways of arranging the components to achieve this. This is the way I would normally do it. By the way, all resistor values are guessed. I didn't perform any analysis to find the perfect values. The transistor in this arrangement connects and disconnects the LED to ground. Except for very brief spikes, the LED only is on when the control voltage at the base is high. I'm pulsing the supply voltage to prove it's actually doing something. This configuration won't work in my electronic trainer kit because the kit permanently attaches the LEDs to ground, probably through a resistor. I could use my own LEDs, but I'll choose to use the ones in the kit. I use this configuration in the robot arm I created in high school. A capacitor is put in parallel with the motor to smooth out the current spikes that can occur if the motor shaft gets stuck, or even just when the motor is first started. In my robot arm, I didn't use diodes across the relays, but I should have. A diode across an inductor, in this case a relay, is referred to as a flyback, or freewheeling, or kickback diode. It eliminates flyback, which is the voltage spikes that can occur when the supply current to an inductor is suddenly reduced or interrupted. This diode will protect the switching transistor. The circuit doesn't include the polarity reversing circuitry I used to change the direction of the motors. This was done with a double pole, double throw relay. In LTSpice, you can create sub-circuits much like you can in Logisim. You can draw the circuit symbol, including contacts. Here's the relay sub-circuit. I used a voltage-controlled switch, and to make it somewhat similar to a relay, I put in an inductor. I modeled a motor with just a resistor, though I guess an inductor really should be in there as well. As you can see, the motor turns on when it should. Here's an LTSpice simulation of the robot arm circuit with reversing capability using the LTSpice 4 plus expansion libraries. Their relays look better than mine. This is the second transistor switching configuration. This one connects and disconnects the LED to the supply voltage. This would work in my electronic kit, and it works as expected. This is the third transistor switching configuration. This one shorts out the LED when the control voltage at the base is high. Therefore, this acts as an inverter. As you can see, the LED follows the supply voltage only when the control voltage is low. This configuration will also work in my electronic kit, so let's create this one. Here's the circuit built on this old Heathkit electronics trainer. The clock set to 1 Hz supplies the power to the LED, and the switch turns on and off the control voltage to the base of the transistor. The LED should blink when the switch is off, and not be lit at all when the switch is on. This is the first transistor I used. Seems bad. This is another 2222 transistor. It's bad too. This one works. By the way, if you want to use this circuit but with non-inverting switching, you might want to use one of these 7404 hex inverter chips to invert the control voltage. It's now non-inverting. Since there are 6 inverters on this chip, let's invert the source clock voltage too. I don't need to because there's already an inverted clock signal in this kit, but let's do it anyway. And I'll also show the kit's inverted clock. Please subscribe, like, share, comment, etc. And if you click subscribe, click the bell to receive notifications of future videos.